Hey there, it's Monday, July 11th. I am out in Plush, Oregon again. I am out here for the Spectrum Sunstone Mine, which the BLM doesn't allow them to have too many signs. And the signs that they do have on the road don't really tell you how to get there. And you have to go through the Sunstone Res in order to get to the Spectrum Sunstone Mine. I apparently missed the first turn, which, from what I'm told, is one of the right-hand turns right after you pull out of the campground in the Sunstone Reservation area. So I am deeper inside, and it's right behind me over there. So I'm going to try and make the road work for me. I'm going to grab my pickaxe because I just walked this road and I'm almost to an entrance. And I'm going to make it work for me. And I have some time to spend on the Sunstones and learning about Sunstones with Spectrum. And it looks like they have a lot of stuff going on there. So it should be a pretty good video. And on to that.
Getting work done.
No great time starts without an adventure. I made it. I made it. Well, I finally made it out to Spectrum. I've told you a few times about the fiascos between me making it out here, but I finally made it out here, and because of one of my other mines canceling, I have plenty of time. So that's a good thing. It's about noon, maybe close to 1:30 or 12:30 right now. I'm going to give you an overview of what the place looks like today. They're, you know, only about 4 hours from stopping their daily mining activities for the most part. So I'm gonna walk around and give you a view of their camping area and the cottages they have, and you can see the teepees in the background. They're pretty cool. So here we go. So these are the cottages that they have for rent out here for anybody that doesn't have any amenities to stay in or doesn't want to stay in a tent. Right on the back side of those cottages is some sort of digging area. Don't know for what or what color, but there's a digging area on the back side of the cottages. And then this little road right here leads to the camping area. Areas for RVs and trailers and tenting. And I'm gonna walk down the rest of the mining area and give you some more view. So this looks like one of the other roads that you can come in on. Not one that I came in on, but there's all kinds of heavy equipment for working over here. And right behind me, it's also the road that leads to the camping area. There's another pit and area to dig in, or where they dig, either one, just beyond this road. They have this sign directing you to the main office down that road, and the cabins and some other pits that they have are down this right here. So we're gonna go this direction and give you a little view of the office. Let's see how we do with the jiggle and the walking and the wind. I got the mic cupped in my hand, but I'm not sure if that's gonna matter. Now they have holes in the ground dug everywhere. So as they were telling me at the front office, at night it's best to stick to the roads. You don't want to go falling in an 11-foot deep hole. Although I have to say, I was out here the other night and it was pretty bright, right? Just with the stars. Pretty bright just with the stars. See pits everywhere. Area for working the sifters and the high-grade piles. And you've got your main office area and where you check in at. They have a bunch of cool rocks in there and crystals and different kinds of specimens I saw when I was in the office for a few minutes. And of course, I'm on anybody's team that flies a pirate flag. Quick view of the outside real quick and some of the stuff they have in the boxes right here. And then that'll pretty much be it for your walking tour of the mine. You got sunstones and turquoise and agate and hematite and all kinds of stuff. Big giant smoky quartz crystals from Nevada. Some trilobite fossils from Utah. And some thunder eggs. And over here we have the, where I drove in at coming through the public lands. It took me a little bit, but I found the route. And another big pit they have dug. And there's your walking tour. So I am standing over at the screening area with a couple of new friends I just met, and Levi is over here working on this pile that you see right there that little man just walked right in front of. That is a $200 pile of high grade for you to sift through and see what you can find. Now it's just like almost sifting anywhere else, except for all you really need to do is throw a shovel full inside of the screen and rinse the screen and see what kind of sunstones you have in there. It's pretty easy. And you can find some amazing stuff. I've already seen one of the stones that they found, which is amazingly big, and I'm sure they'll let us show that to you here in a little while.
So Levi here is going to show us his screening of a shovel full of the ore that he has. Now for $200, you get what looks like a 2-yard dump bucket. Is what it looks like to me, but I'm just guessing, I'm not sure. But they already pulled one monstrous stone out of here that's well worth the $200 they spent on it. And by looking at the pile, it looks like it might be a full day's work even for two people. Looks like it might be more than a day's work for one person.
Yeah.
And he's over here shaking his head, even though you can't see it bobbing up and down. But yeah, we're in agreement on that for $200, it's at least a full day's work, probably for two people. One person real good could probably burn through it, or if they're only looking for really big stuff.
Yeah.
You see him plucking some stuff out of there. The big one they found inside the pile as right after it got dumped, apparently. Didn't even have to look very hard. We'll show you that in a minute. It's a gorgeous one. Over 100 carats, easy. Not quite like screening for sapphires where you need to shake everything and get it towards the bottom. It's definitely more like just looking and picking. Wash the dirt off and just sift around and find the good stuff. Let's see what you got in your hands. Do like that real quick.
Got a little color in there.
Some yellow and pink, a little bit of pink in there.
Yeah.
The light is messing with me, but there we go. That's good. Thank you.
No problem.
And I don't think we need to show 5 minutes of that, do we? 2 minutes probably works. I'll show you the bag they have here in a second.
Got one thing.
Check the bottom of the screen. Make sure you didn't miss anything from the top. It's a really good idea that Levi was like, yeah, we didn't do this part, and that's a really good idea because I wouldn't have thought of that on my own. And then dump it. There you go. Screening for sunstones.
So tomorrow I'm probably going to be doing some digging, and I don't know what color comes out of this hole, but this is a massive undertaking that they have done on this pit right here. Like, I don't know how bad that wind is too. I'm trying to block it. This pit is ridiculous. Now when you look at stuff like this, I can understand. You gotta try and find something like this on the BLM if you wanna find some really good stones. Those stuff I pulled out on my video, from what somebody told me, that comes out a lot from the, he called it the cap rock. And he said about 6 more feet down, I'd start pulling out some clear, bigger crystals with color in them. So, I didn't know where I could get 6 more feet down and to soft lava rock like that, but we're here to learn and adventure and find. It's a pretty cool pit though. Looks like a lot of adventure and digging. After about 5 hours worth of work, these are the sunstones that Levi and Michelle pulled out of their $200 pile. They have one seriously amazing one. It is 104 carats. It has Schiller reflection in it. It has red on this end, and it has color change on this end. It has Schiller with a green and red on the end, that the green changes to red when you're looking at it in different angles. And it is, like I said, 104 carats. And the mine says that it's about $7 a carat in the rough like this.
So that is a really good pull for one stone. Besides the one stone though, out of their bucket, you know, this is everything else that was in there. There are some reds in here, and there are some ones with a little bit of shiller, and there's a whole lot of yellow and clear. But it seems like they got a pretty good bucket. Here's a really nice red one. It's got two little areas of red in it. So for $200, it seems like they got a really good bucket for $200. The other bucket I saw clean today didn't have this monster in it, but they did have a lot of nice red that came out of it. So they got some good red. So that's a pretty good bucket, I expect. Not what I think everybody would get. I know not everybody gets it, but they still got some really good stones in there. So that's a sifted bucket for today. And tomorrow we should be doing some digging with you. And hopefully somebody will buy a conveyor belt run and we'll be able to get some of that video. So we'll see you here in a little while. Maybe I'll get some of the res. Good morning. It is a beautiful morning out here at Spectrum Sunstone Mine. And I realized something yesterday when I was taking some of those pictures that you saw a minute ago before the sun went down, that there's signs at all the pits. So all the pits pretty much have a name. You know, the pit right here, that pit right there is the office pit. That makes sense because it's, oh, that's right. Don't spin too fast, Coleco. Because it's right across from the office, right? So you got like the office pit right there. That's a pretty obvious one, right? And then this pit over here that is on this side of that dozer and by those big hills, those big sand tailings piles, that is the bear's den. You can see the sign right there, the bear's den. And then I don't see the sign for this pit, but I'm sure there's one around here or something. I think there was something barbecue. This is something barbecue, like the Donner barbecue or something like that. Here's the sign. Yeah, Donner Party Barbecue Pit. Somebody's got a morbid sense of humor. And over here it says Troll Crossing. So here's the conveyor belt. I believe we're going to be lucky enough to see how that works today. So we're going to see how that works today. What's the pit back here called? Okay, and the pit that's all the way back here down this little road is called the Coyote Pit. And I know there is a pit called the Cattle Guard, and there is also one they call the Red Pit and one they call the Green Pit. And after talking to some of the employees over the last day, I've pretty much found out that both colors of stones can come out of any of the pits. So it's not like there is a absolute specific, like one pit is not gonna only have red and one pit's not gonna only have green. They all have the potential to pull out, you know, any of them. And that doesn't surprise me too much because, you know, it's not like we're wandering around in miles. It's this area. So on that note, when we get to digging, we'll see what we get out of a pit and where they end up putting us. I'm excited to see what happens on the conveyor belt, so the next time I'm here, maybe I'll spend the money. It feels like the wind is completely going in the microphone, so I'd hate this video to be ruined by that last little section. Yeah, totally. All right, so this is the pit and the area in the pit I'm going to be digging at today. The price for pit digging is $100 to $200 per person per sectioned off area. And you can pretty much see my section. It's in between the harder rock right there. It's already been dug a little bit. So this is where I'm gonna be digging. I'm going to be using pickaxes, possibly sledgehammer and point and chisel, shovel, gloves, shaker box. And you'll be seeing all that in action here in a few minutes, hoping to find major cool sunstones. We be hoping. So I really didn't have any true idea what I was doing. When I had read up on sunstones online, a lot of it had said that bigger sunstones will be trapped inside matrices of smaller crushed sunstones. The whole sort of greenish-white area underneath the red stone I'm working at, all of it looks like that. There's just tons of tiny little sunstones coming out. Nothing of any real significance. So I'm just sort of knocking around the whole area, hoping to see something large. I don't ever really end up seeing anything large come out, but when I'm using my shaker box, I definitely find sunstones and sunstones with color in them that I missed when I was just, you know, using my hammer and hoping to see some large crystals or a pocket or something. But once again, I really didn't have too much of an idea what I was doing, so I was trying to learn while I went. What I started doing was, while I was knocking off the old basalt into sort of a pile in front of me, and I was sweeping it with my hand all into one pile out of the way and to the side, so that I was building up a specific tailings pile that I could then throw into the sifter box and sift through. So I'd know exactly where everything I had dug was, because there was all kinds of decayed matter all around me. In all honesty, for the amount of time that I spent there digging and using my hammer, if I would have known I was going to be there for a shorter period of time, I think I just would have used the sifter box and sifted all of the tailings in the area that were there before I even got there. I think I would have found a lot more sunstones instead of, you know, swinging my hammer. So here I'm going to be using the sifter box, and it's pretty simple. It's like any other dry sifter. You know, you throw a couple of shovelfuls of dirt into the box and you shake it around and pluck some of the sunstones out and put them in a different area and maybe shake the box a couple more times, see if you find anything, and dump the box out and repeat that process. It's a little bit labor intensive, but not too difficult at all. They supply the sifters in the boxes for the people at the Spectrum Sunstone Mine. When you're sifting through your rough and you're pulling out the good stones, you don't just want to grab the stones that you see with color in them. You want to grab all the stones. And Spectrum Sunstone Mine, they want you to grab all of the stones too. They don't want you throwing sunstones in the discard pile just because they're clear or yellow. And after the time that I got to look at my sunstones later, there's a really good reason for that, especially with the shiller. If you haven't actually washed them with water, it's really easy to think that you have just a clear or a yellow sunstone because you didn't see the reflection of the shiller at the proper angle. So take all the sunstones with you, wash them when you get home, look at them under a light. So after some of the conversations I've had with people and after working a little bit, you can see what I've done with my hole. The basalt, the top is hard, and that's the capstone. It'll be like that. Well, that's not even hard, but up on top it'll be even harder than that. And then the lower you get down, the more the basalt is disintegrating. Like this, you can see the red clay right there. It's not actually clay. That used to be lava rock. but now it's more like clay. And then this is the, seems to be the substrate, I guess, that the labradorite and feldspar, the sunstones, are in. And this is what it's like after it's been decomposed, and it's a bit easier to chop at times. It tends to come out like this. Sometimes it seems like it's really sticky clay, or like this over here, it's almost more like a rock. When I get it like that, it might have a crystal in it, I always tend to think, so I get to be a little bit more cautious and start tapping. But I've had a couple good-sized sunstones come out of here, not with any color yet. The best thing with color I found was within the first couple of minutes of just cleaning the tailings out of the area I was going to be working in. But I've definitely seen them come out of the wall. And like, there's little ones right there. Little one just fell out. So we're looking for this stuff. Seems to have sunstones in it. All of it seems to have sunstones in it, but most of them I've been pulling out have been like that. Almost everything I've been finding is basically already shrapnel. And I mean, you can tell it's not for me, but it's definitely for the most part already shrapnel. But I still have a nice mound to sift through. So I'll turn you on when I start sifting some more and I'm not just hammering away at the wall. So I hit this soft spot right here that is not really my tailings. I think it was just falling off of the top right here and that. And I hit a couple of really big pieces of glass. They don't really have any color, although I've found a couple nice pieces that have color in them too. So I'm going to put the camera on the shaker box because I got that feeling something good's gonna come out. On my GPS, it says that there is no gas station within 50 miles, but that's not true. In Plush, there is a gas and groceries and sometimes hot food right here. So they have all kinds of stuff inside and you can fill up, although they're not open late or anything. So there is gas in Plush, even if your phone or your GPS says there's not. Hey there, it's your boy Coleco. So
I did not finish the Spectrum Sunstone mine video the way I wanted to. I sort of ruined my welcome at the Sunstone mine by not being there when I told the people that owned the mine I was going to be there. I ended up being, you know, two or three times not there when I thought I was going to be there. And that's just the way my life rolls sometimes, especially when I'm on the road and I'm going from mine to mine. It just works out that way. And I've learned to be like water and sort of just roll with things as they're going, and that's what's worked out best for me. And this time it sort of shot me in the foot. I'm gonna show you the sunstones I have right here in front of me that I got. I only dug in the hole that you saw on video for about 2.5-3 hours, maybe 3 hours. I took a long lunch break in between. I didn't learn as much as I wanted to. I found more colored sunstones, I found out today, than I thought I had when I left Spectrum. I found the sunstones I got are all Schiller sunstones. There's no red, there's no green. I'm still rather happy because I didn't expect to have as many colored sunstones as I do. And what I'm going to show you when I go over the sunstones is that you take all the sunstones with you when you leave, right? You want to take them all and you want to wash them all at home and then go over them with a light like you would any other good gemstone, because the light really reflecting through there will really make the pieces that have just a little hint of Schiller in them really stick out, as opposed to the clear or yellow sunstones. So I'm going to show you that. I'm going to show you the sunstones I got right now. So these are the two piles of sunstones I have. These ones are the ones with color and some larger ones that I've already pulled out. They have Schiller color in them, no red or no green. And this is the other pile of sunstones that are purely clear or small, and I haven't found the Schiller flash in them yet, if there is one to be found in it. I'm guessing that the hole or the section that I was digging in would have cost me $100 for the day. I only dug for about 3 hours and this is what I got for it. I'll talk about ratings in a second. So these are pretty cool because they're ultra large. There's no real major play of color in them at all. I think there's a little bit of Schiller on like one edge. Schiller is the orange reflective in the center. Let's see if I find a clean one. That you can see that sort of pink peach orange reflection in the center. Let me find a, here we go, this is a good one right there on the tip of it. You can totally see it. It's got good red, good Schiller flash in it. So, anyways, this is my total haul. I think it's pretty good. I think digging in the ground, it seems like they point you where they want you to go. It doesn't seem like you have much of an option. Maybe if you're a regular there, I'm sure you probably have more of an option than somebody that, you know, knows nothing and knows nobody like I do. You know, they have pretty much three different options. They have the buckets for $200, which you saw a couple go through earlier. They have $1 to $200 to dig in a pit, and I really couldn't get a good explanation on, you know, is it $200 for a green pit and $100 for a red pit, or, you know, why the variations or the prices are the way they're. I really couldn't get an explanation on that at all, so maybe you can if you go there. But it really seemed to me like the best bang for your buck was in the machine. Now, I saw a family go through, you know, a bucket load on day one while I was there, and they found a lot of stones, but nothing really super dramatic. And then on day two, they went and did the machine, and they stopped by my pit while I was digging, and they were extremely excited about what they got out of the machine, which makes me think that... Let me rephrase that.
while I was there, it seemed like the employees were telling the customers that what the machine would process in the hour was the same amount of rough that they were dumping in a pile for $200. And I think that machine can process a lot more. And after talking to the family that paid for the machine for 2 hours, they seemed like it was a much better deal too. So bang for your buck, I think, is in the machine. Overall, you know, they seem to have, they have porta potties. They have some cabins that are free for some diggers. You know, overall, I think they're a 4-star joint, but I really didn't get enough time there, and I couldn't afford enough time there to give you a full in-depth review. I couldn't get them to run the machine for me just even to get some video of it, although I know there's video of it, but I think they're a 4-star place, but I'm only going to give them 3 stars on my own personal feel, you know? Maybe when I come back there and I have at least $600 or $700 to spend on Sunstones, I'll have a better review for you, because I'm going to spend more time out there. I'm really disappointed with my overall trips to Plush, and I'm definitely going to do them again next year, if not, you know, sooner. So Plush is back on the menu, better videos, more stones found, I promise you. Like, share, subscribe. Is this the end? I think this is the end.